Take a breath. Go ahead. What's the most important thing you just inhaled? You inhaled a mixture of gases, 20% of which was oxygen, the important one. And when you inhale the oxygen, you use it up. Now, how is it then that there's always oxygen around? In fact, the percentage of the atmosphere that's oxygen stays right about 20%. Well, you might know it's because trees are making that oxygen. This is a good example of equilibrium, where oxygen stays at a nice level amount, even though I'm using it, because trees are offsetting that by making it, so it stays nice and level. A sort of equilibrium. We call it an equilibrium because it stays the same. We call it dynamic because I'm constantly using oxygen while the trees are making it. Does that make sense? If not, that's okay, because equilibrium like that is complicated. Equilibrium exists also for chemical reactions, and that's what we're going to study in today's lab. We're going to simulate a chemical reaction by taking scoops of water from one bucket, which will represent reactants, to another bucket, which will represent products. We'll see that when we do this, eventually an equilibrium is established, and hopefully by the end of this lab, you'll feel comfortable with the idea of equilibrium. Let's take a look. Let's begin by reviewing our lesson objectives. First, we'll introduce the required materials. Then, we'll review equilibrium. And lastly, we'll introduce the lab procedure. Well, let's start with those required materials. You'll need two bowls. These are going to be filled with water that represents reactants and products. And we're going to simulate a reaction by taking a 1/2 cup measure or a 1/3 cup measure and scooping back and forth. Each time after we scoop water back and forth, we'll measure the height of the water with centimeters, so you need a ruler that has centimeters on it. You also will want a dry erase marker to label each bowl as reactants or products. If you don't have a dry erase marker, you can use a sheet of paper and just write reactants or products and put it in front of the bowl that represents either reactants or products. All right, well, here are your materials to gather. If you're ready to proceed, you can pause the video and gather all of those materials and then come back and finish the lesson. All right, well, what is chemical equilibrium? Chemical equilibrium is when a chemical reaction runs forward and backwards. So here we have a chemical reaction, and the red sphere representing an atom combines with the green sphere representing an atom. They join together to form a molecule on the right. But this reaction, represented by the forwards and backwards arrows, runs both ways. So we could also have our reactants be just that molecule joined together, which splits apart as shown there on the right. Let's track the concentrations over time. Here we have a graph representing concentration over time, and the blue line tells us how much products we have. We can see that it's already risen just a bit, and the reactants have dropped. And that's what typically happens in a reaction. You start with a bunch of reactants, and they slowly disappear, and the products slowly form. That process will continue, but eventually level out, as you see in this pink region. And so notice at the end, there's still reactants and products, but the concentrations aren't changing. That's equilibrium. So what is chemical equilibrium? It's a stable balance between reactants and products. It's when the reaction is, quote, finished. So here in the pink, our reaction has a stable balance of the reactants and products. Those aren't changing. However, the details are a little more complicated here because equilibrium is dynamic. What does that mean? Well, it's a bit like our chemical reaction is a bus. Here we see a woman getting off the bus and a man getting on the bus. So one person gets off, one person gets on, but the same number of people are on the bus. Chemical equilibrium is the same way. Imagine that our products represent those things on the bus. We have reactants hopping on and products hopping off, but the total balance is stable. The goal in this lab is to simulate dynamic equilibrium, so you can really understand this concept, which is a little tricky. First, you'll label one bowl R and one P for reactants and products. Then you'll fill up the R bowl, that's the reactants bowl, about 2/3 full. Then we'll measure the height of water in both bowls and report it on our table. Keep in mind that the height of water in your product should start out as zero. Then you'll perform one swap. That's taking water forward and backwards. It looks like this. First, you'll place the 1/2 cup measure vertically in the reactants bowl and gently tilt it upward. It won't be full necessarily. Then transfer the water to the products bowl. That's running the reaction forward. Then the reaction will be run backwards by placing the 1/3 cup measure vertically in the products bowl and gently tilting it upwards and transferring it to the reactants bowl. Congratulations, you've performed a swap. Let's watch that take place. We have our reaction set up now. On the left, we have a bowl full of red liquid representing the reactants. And on the right, we have an empty bowl labeled P for products. There's no products yet. Before we get started, let's measure the height of our reactants and our products to get a sense of how much reactants and products we have at the moment. So we measure the height of our reactants with the ruler, and then we measure the height of products, though, of course, the height of the products right now is zero. Next, let's simulate our chemical reaction. We'll do this by taking a measuring cup and dipping it vertically into the reactants cup. And now what we'll do is gently scoop it up forward so that just some liquid is in the cup. It doesn't need to be full. Then we pour that in the products bowl. That simulates the reaction running forward. Now we'll simulate the reaction running backwards by doing the same thing in our product bowl. Notice we basically get no products on our first reverse step. Okay, that's one swap, running it forward once and running it backwards once. After that, we'll measure the height of our reactants and our products again with the ruler. Now we should get some number for both the reactants and the products, not zero products, but very little on the product side. We're going to continue that process, running our reactants forward to products by taking our dipper, dipping it down, gently scooping up, and scooping it over to products. That's our forward step. And then once again, a reverse step by running from the products back to reactants. We'll continue going back and forth like this until the height of the bowls don't change. That will represent equilibrium. All right, well, after you've performed a swap, we'll remeasure the height of water in both bowls and report it on our table. You're going to repeat until the heights in both bowls remain the same after a swap. So that means you're still running it forwards and backwards, but the height's not changing. When that happens, you've found dynamic equilibrium. Congratulations. What will this look like on our table? Well, here's our table, and on the left represents reaction time. And it's measured in number of swaps. So at zero swaps, we're going to measure the height of our reactants and products. And you should have some height for reactants and a zero for your products. So it won't be exactly this, but this is just an example. And then we'll continue performing swaps and remeasuring for some number of swaps. We don't know how many that will be, but here's the key. Notice in this question mark swap, we have a height of 3.8 centimeters for reactants and 2.2 centimeters for products. And we perform one more swap and it doesn't change. That's what we're looking for that will indicate to you that you've found that dynamic equilibrium. Let's review what we've learned. We introduced the required materials. We reviewed equilibrium, which we said was a stable balance of reactants and products, and that it's dynamic, which means it's still the case that the reaction is running forwards and backwards, but the balance of reactants and products isn't changing. Then we introduced the lab procedure where we saw how we'll simulate this dynamic equilibrium with these bowls of water. Hey, hey.